Glenn's got this kind of incredibly inventive way of keeping everything practical.
It was part of our agenda from the beginning to build real versions of our futuristic cars.
I saw these hover cars and I was like, we're gonna have something really special there.
A lot of people just assume that you're gonna go the CG route because you can, and there's certain things you simply cannot do practically. But if you can try, then I will. Well, here's how we're gonna do the hover car sequence. We're gonna build six of them, and we're gonna put them on these chassis, and we're gonna drive them around.
And beat the living bejesus out of each other.
In the film, we wanted these cars to look like they are levitating. In order to make that practical, we are actually building our cars on top of another car. So they're gonna basically erase it out of the final picture.
This is my wife.
You're married?
It's safe to say we're separated.
So they had two drivers in these cage cars. One driver operated a model hover car that was on top.
That actually allows the car to tilt, spin around, but you get angles that you really would get in a chase with futuristic cars.
Here, you drive.
The other driver operated the car beneath that just drove it around.
We have them racing down the street, talking to each other. So you have the vibration, you have the feel, you have their performance reflecting the reality of it at every turn.
And literally they would slam into each other at 40 miles an hour with us on top.
We're trying to get physical reality to be our starting point, like people in cars reacting to G-forces as they turn around corners. If you do it for real, you've got it for real. You've got them doing their real reactions. It's actually a really hard thing to fake.
They've got the lock on the vehicle.
But it was great fun. It was really great fun.
You're gonna need your seatbelt on!
I would look to Colin. Wow, this is so cool. I love my job.
You got it?
Yes!